write down for a rigid body, we are trying to find the angular momentum. Two cases we'll consider, like always, fixed axis and rotation plus translation. Okay, so if the entire rigid body is moving with the same velocity, it is not rotating, it is as good as a point mass is moving, and you can consider entire rigid body as if it is a point mass located at the center of mass. So you can, that case we already considered. Okay, now we are considering case number one. Fixed axis. ये रहा तुम्हारा rigid body, this is your rigid body, fine. And this rigid body, देखो बकवास करना बंद करो, focus करो यहाँ पे. This is a rigid body which can rotate about this fixed axis. Alright, ठीक है भाई. I want to find out the angular momentum of the entire rigid body with respect to this axis. Fine. So I am giving you hints. You derive yourself. Just like we have derived the kinetic energy of a rigid body about a fixed axis. Same way, please do that. Let's say this is point mass m1 at a distance at a perpendicular distance r1 away, and angular velocity is omega. This m2 at a perpendicular distance r2 away. Now start doing it. Try doing it your way. Anybody?
I omega.
I about the fixed axis into omega. How many of you got that? 2, 3, 4. All right, let us do this. The velocity of m1 in tangential direction will be how much? This velocity will be omega into r1, right? Okay, so the angular momentum of point mass m1 is r1 into m1 omega r1. This will come out to be m1 r1 square omega. Similarly, L2 will come out to be M2 R2 square omega, like that. Okay, so if you add it up, you get total angular momentum. And kya naam hai iska? Chetan, Chetanya, put it down wahan se. Kahan baithega? Sit there.
No, so it's very uncomfortable there,
so that is why I'm putting you there, na?
I won't talk, please, sir. I can't ride.
So if you talk next, then
next
what will
happen?
No, then something extra should be there, right? Then what you'll do? You still talk.
I don't know.
You'll sit here.
Yeah.
Without okay? Fine. How, what kind of punishments you get in school? Get out of the class.
We don't.
Huh?
Yeah, they actually don't give us punishment. Is he?
What? No punishment.
They still shout at us and then that's all.
My teacher used to hit me. No punishments.
So then you
hit them. They just scream at
us. That's so... You will not have any stories to tell. Anyways, how should I punish?
So then you can hit the.
I'll be in a jail. That I will not do. To innovate, embarrass, being sarcastic, then what? Shouting to the routine thing. Then what else? Stand on the chair. with wheels on it.
That's just hitting me four steps.
Okay. Or stand here and what you're talking, explain to everyone. Like, if there's some joke you're cracking, you're smiling, come here and let everyone smile. Tell everyone what you're talking. Something like that. Okay. Fine, so if you add up all the angular momentums, you get the total angular momentum of a rigid body. Fine. And when you talk about the total angular momentum of a rigid body, you use capital L for it. So capital L is summation of mi ri square times omega. Right? Omega is constant, so comes out. This will be equal to I about fixed axis into omega. This is the angular momentum about the fixed axis. It's coming out so simply. Just like kinetic energy came out simply for the fixed axis as half I about the fixed axis into omega square, angular momentum also comes out very nicely like that. Right? If you differentiate it, what do you get? IF into I alpha, which is equal to
dot.
Dot.
This is
getting it? Okay. Do you remember force is equal to rate at which linear momentum changes, F is equal to dp by dt? That is more basic, or F is equal to m into A?
It's dp by dt.
Dp by dt, right? Even mass can change, there will be a force. V dm by dt is also force. Okay. Similarly here, torque is also equal to omega di by dt. Okay, it is not just I into d omega by dt, it can be omega into di by dt also. Getting it? So this is case number one, fixed axis. Now we are trying to derive the for the translational axis. Alright? Stop talking. So, angular momentum in this case will be equal to, please write down, ICM into omega plus R center of mass cross M into VCM. This is the total angular momentum. Fine. This is about which axis? This is, suppose this is the rigid body. It's a rigid body going with VCM like this. And let's say angular velocity is omega. I am trying to find out angular momentum of the entire rigid body with respect to this point, which is such that this vector is your RCM vector. Getting it? RCM is a position vector of the center of mass with respect to a point about which you are finding the angular momentum. Okay? Usually application of this will not be there. Okay? And even if it is there, you can always say that angular momentum with respect to center of mass. This will be how much? Angular momentum with respect to center of mass is how much? RCM becomes what? Zero. Position vector of center of mass with respect to itself is zero. So moment, angular momentum about center of mass is always, no matter what the rigid body is doing, is ICM omega. Okay? And sometimes center of mass axis is your fixed axis also. Yeah. Okay. Right? Any doubts? No doubts. There's a full mathematical derivation of this also. We are not getting into that. That is of no use. Yeah.
So when the ball is spinning about the z axis, if we have, we just take ICM omega.
Yes. And it is a vector quantity, alright? It's a vector quantity. Alright, next topic, please write down. See, we are soon we are about to finish this chapter's theory. Okay, then we'll solve only numericals. We are towards the end of the theory of this chapter. Okay, write down angular impulse. So I know that torque is equal to rate at which angular momentum changes for a rigid body. Fine? It is very similar to force equals to rate at which the linear momentum changes for a point mass. These equations are similar. Fine? So torque dt integral is equal to integral of dl, which is equal to change in angular momentum. Similarly here, this what we have already learned. This left hand side is what? This one?
Impulse. It's impulse.
Impulse. Linear impulse denoted by what letter?
J.
So J vector is equal to change of linear momentum. Okay. Similarly, the angular impulse, there is no letter as such assigned for angular impulse. Okay. So it is, that's what, integral of torque dt is your angular impulse. This is your angular impulse. This is equal to change in the angular momentum. Okay. And how do you get angular impulse? There should be torque for a very short span of time. Okay. Any doubts here? No doubt, then we can take a question on this, because this is little vague, this concept. Any doubts? You have a rod like this. Okay. You are giving an impulse from here. This is the impulse J. Impulse is given. You need to find out velocity of center of mass and omega. The rod was stationary on the horizontal surface. Mass M and length L. Uniform rod. Can I use impulse is equal to rate of change of linear momentum over here?
So you have,
sorry, not rate of change of linear momentum over here.
Change of linear momentum plus angular momentum. So because it can translate and rotate.
Whatever you have learned, everything is valid, but for the center of mass. Okay? Whatever you have learned with respect to linear impulse and everything, everything is valid with respect to center of mass. So you can say that J is equal to change of linear momentum, which is M into VCM minus 0. VCM is what? J by M.
Wait, sir, but isn't J equal to M VCM plus I omega?
No. Getting it? You derived it, right? J is equal to change of linear momentum. If it is a rigid body, for the center of mass. Simple. Okay? Now, we have to also apply the angular impulse is equal to change of the angular momentum. Right? Now, is there a fixed axis?
No.
No fixed axis. Right? Alright? So, kya hua? No, it is not fixed. It is placed on the horizontal surface and impulse J is given at the end. It is not fixed. Fine. But angular impulse is there. About which point angular impulse is there? Is angular impulse is there with respect to this?
No.
About that?
Yes.
About everywhere else there is angular impulse. But if you write about any random point, writing angular momentum becomes difficult. It will be ICM omega plus RCM into MVCM, right? But if you write angular impulse with respect to center of mass, it will be simply equal to ICM omega, yes or no? right? So I'll calculate angular momentum with respect to center of mass. How much that will be?
So it'll be this divided by.
It'll be simply linear impulse into L by 2. How it comes? J is what? Integral of f dt, right? And the angular impulse is integral of tau dt. Tau is what? F into L by 2. This is equal to L by 2 integral f dt, which is L by 2 into J. Same thing. Okay? Clear? So J into L by 2 is equal to the angular momentum change with respect to center of mass axis. So this will be what? M L square by 12 into omega. So you'll get omega also here. What you'll get?
Six
J by
ML.
Are you guys comfortable with this concept? Okay. So find out the point which is at rest immediately after impulse is given.
No. That.
Find out location of a point which is at rest immediately after impulse is given. Okay. And if you are getting the answer immediately, it is wrong. Do something. Write it down.
No,
it has to be that end.
No. That end might move back.
It is not that end.
So what's the condition for there being a point at rest and there being no points at rest?
Net velocity is zero for the point at rest. Velocity is zero, right? For an object with point which is at rest.
So it's not necessary that there will be a point at rest here.
But there is.
So it's 1/6 from
left. 1/6 from? Right hand side or left hand side?
It will be that
right.
What?
Who's right? Right of center.
Wow, what are we doing? Crop. Stand up. You.
Me.
Sit there. So, ऐसे दिखा रहे हैं सर मतलब कि किया ही नहीं.
No, I actually didn't.
Oh, what?
I didn't think you.
Every criminal say that I haven't done it. Alright, listen here. So angular velocity is omega like this. VCM is how? VCM is like that. So if you take a point over here which is at a distance of let's say d, what will be its total velocity? Omega into d like this. This is omega d plus VCM. Yes or no? This is the total velocity. So no point can be at rest over here because the angular component and the linear component, they are adding up. Over here though, it will be omega into, let's say, distance of y. So there is omega y and there will be VCM. So total velocity will be VCM minus omega y. Okay? So you have to find out a point where VCM minus omega y becomes 0. So y will be what? VCM by
omega.
Karo VCM by omega. You get L by 6.
Yes.
So a point which is L by 6 on the left hand side will be at rest immediately after collision. No, collision, the impulse. By the way, impulse comes from collision. Getting it? This is slightly tricky concept, but it requires little bit of problem practice and then you're fine with that. Not a lot of varieties will be there with angular impulse. So you can just solve a couple of numericals and you're fine. Alright, so this is the angular impulse.